Hello, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to make a seamless Moroccan trellis pattern in Illustrator. You can also use Photoshop for this. Just follow the link in the video description to view the full Photoshop tutorial on my blog. We are going to start by making the Moroccan trellis shape, and then we are going to use the pattern tool to turn it into a seamless pattern. We are going to use the shape tools for that. So switch to the ellipse tool, the shortcut is L, set the fill color to black and remove the stroke. Now click on your canvas and create a circle that's 100 pixels by 100 pixels. Now I'm going to switch to the selection tool and I am going to duplicate this circle. Click on the circle to select it and then hold down the Alt or Option key if you are on a Mac. Click on the circle and drag to create another copy. Also hold down the Shift key to make sure both circles are perfectly aligned. If you have the smart guides turned on, you will see these purple lines that will help you align the circles. If your smart guides are not turned on, you can go to View and click on Smart Guides. Now I am going to select both circles and I am going to group them. You can right click on them and select group, or you can press Ctrl G. Now go back to the shape tools and select the rectangle tool. The shortcut is M. We are going to create a rectangle that has the same width as our circles, so 100 pixels, but it's taller than them. I am going to enter 150 pixels. Then press OK. I am going to switch back to the selection tool and I am going to select all the items. I am going to make sure Align to Artboard is selected and then I am going to align their centers. Let's select the shapes again and then go to Window, Pathfinder and click on Merge to turn the three shapes into a single shape. Now I am going to remove the fill color and set a black stroke. Let's select the ellipse tool again and I am going to create another circle that's 100 pixels by 100 pixels. It has no fill and a black stroke. We will have to divide the circle into four parts. To do that, I'm going to use the direct selection tool. The shortcut is A. So I am going to click somewhere on the artboard and then I am going to click on a circle. And if you see these handles, it means that just the area between two anchor points is selected. And then you can press Ctrl X. As you can see, that part of the circle was cut, and then you can press Ctrl V to paste it. Now I am going to switch to the direct selection tool again and I am going to select another part of the circle, then press Ctrl X again and Ctrl V to paste it. I am going to do the same for the other part of the circle. Let's create the shape. We will have to move this quarter of the circle that was in the lower right part to the upper left part. The lower left part will go in the upper right part of our shape. We are going to do the same for the upper part of the circle and move it down here. If you have the smart guides turned on, it will be much easier to arrange all the items. These areas have to be perfectly aligned in order to have a seamless pattern. So I am going to select the upper arcs. I am going to go to the Align panel. Make sure Align to Key Object is selected. And then I am going to vertically align their centers. I am going to do the same for the lower part of the circle and then for the left and right. Now all we have left to do is to remove these two lines. So I am going to switch to the direct selection tool again, click on the line and then press delete. Going to do the same for the lower part. And now let's switch to the selection tool, select all of them and group them. Now we are going to use the shape builder tool. The shortcut is shift plus M. And I am just going to go over the whole shape. And if you switch back, you can see that it's now a shape. It's not formed of many smaller shapes. And if you want, you can make the stroke a little bit thicker. To turn this into a seamless pattern, just select the shape and then go to Object, Pattern, Make. This will open the pattern tool and as you can see, it's already a seamless pattern. But if you want, you can add a background. Let's make it pink. And I am going to switch to the rectangle tool. And I'm going to make a rectangle that's the same size as the tile. Just go to arrange and then send it to the back. If you want, you can also select the shape and let's also give it a fill color and let's change the stroke to white. When you are happy with the way your pattern looks, just press done to save it. And it now appears in the swatches panel. So let's delete the shape. And I am going to choose the pattern swatch as the fill color. And I'm going to create a rectangle that's the same size as my artboard. And this is our finished Moroccan trellis pattern. If you want, you can go back to the swatches panel, to the pattern maker, by double clicking on a pattern and you can change the color of your shape or you can change the color of the background. And when you are happy with the pattern, you can press save a copy to save another pattern swatch. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more Photoshop and Illustrator tutorials, please visit my blog or subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching!